right? It's very exciting, okay? Because I feel that this is a super important workshop that everybody should join, okay? The Chinese Wedding Customs Presentation by the Chinese Wedding Workshop. So we have Michelle who will be joining us in a very short while. Ah, she's on screen already. All right. Hi, Michelle. Are you ready?
Hello.
Share with us more?
Yes, yes, yes. Very
okay,
excited.
So without further ado, I'm going to hand this time over to Michelle. But, all right, Guo Da Li, An Chuang. Okay, a talk by the founder of the Chinese Wedding Shop. Michelle will explain to you what you need to know about the different Chinese wedding customs. All right, just to let everybody know, the Chinese Wedding Shop is passionate about Chinese wedding traditions, ensuring that these customs subsist and flourish. Okay, they wish to assist couples in discovering, appreciating and passing on these traditions to future generations. All right, so please ask your questions via the Q&A webinar feature for Michelle to answer your questions during her presentation. Okay, so Michelle, are you ready?
Yes, thank you.
All right, so over to you, Michelle.
Okay. Hello, everybody. Thank you, Mary Bees. That was a fantastic performance. It was really very nice. I think everyone enjoyed it. So, okay, I'm here to talk to everyone about Guo Da Li, which is a very, very common question. Before we start, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Michelle, and we are actually from the Chinese Wedding Shop. We are a brand that preserves and promotes traditional Chinese wedding customs, as what Mary Bees has explained. And such as Guo Da Li, Jia Zhuang, An Chuang, Shu Tou, and all with a modern tweak. So we have been around for more than 10 years. And we are actually a one-stop station where couples can actually prepare your Guo Da Li, your Jia Zhuang items together, and even order your wedding cakes, and at the same time have a wedding customary consultation according to your dialect groups. So this is actually a free service available at all our outlets. And now during COVID, it's also available across all our communication channels as well. So we are actually in 5 locations all over Singapore. So we have Ang Mo Kio, JEM, which is in Jurong East, Jurong Point, which is in Boon Lay MRT station, Parkway Parade, and Bedok Central. So right now, due to COVID, all our outlets are closed. But you can contact us via email, you can Facebook PM us, you can IG DM us, you can WhatsApp us, or we can actually set up Zoom meetings with you and your parents to answer all the questions that all of you might have. So it's also easier to show you the photos or the items required and explain the customs better via video calls. So if you like a session, please let us know and we can actually set it up for you. Okay, so let's start. What is Guo Da Li? So this is a very common question. Guo Da Li is actually a day when both families will exchange gifts. So on this day, the groom will bring over a lot of food and gift items to pass to the bride's parents. And this is done to show the sincerity of the groom to the bride's family. So when do we do the Guo Da Li? When is it held? Guo Da Li is usually done 2 to 3 weeks before the actual wedding day. But with that said, it's commonly done also a few months before the wedding day itself. Depending on individual circumstances, such as the couple is working overseas or the parents are staying overseas, for example, and you visit them once in a few months. So that's when you can actually do your Guo Da Li. Or when your wedding is immediately after the 7th lunar month and you would like to skip that month to do wedding stuff. So you can also do your Guo Da Li 1 or 2 months before your actual wedding day. So how do we do the Guo Da Li? So as I mentioned, on this day, the groom will bring over a lot of food items and gift items to pass to the bride's parents. So the items to bring over differs family to family, usually according to both the family's dialect groups. Common items that the groom will bring over include the pinjing, the dowry money, the gold jewelry, and auspicious food items such as 12 or 18 oranges, an even number of wedding cakes to be distributed to the bride's relatives, 2 bottles of alcohol, auspicious grains such as red dates, 代表早生贵子, 龙岸, 代表圆圆满满, which is also 桂圆, that's why it's 圆圆满满, then lotus seeds, which is 莲子, 莲莲生子, 百合, 百年好合, winter melon sweets, which is 白头到老, 还有 rock sugar, 甜甜蜜蜜的意思. So these are also the ingredients for the red dates tea for the tea ceremony on the wedding day. A lot of you don't know this, but for the tea ceremony, it is not Chinese tea and it is not green tea. It is actually red dates tea, which is 早生贵子茶. So there will also be a lot of boxes of traditional biscuits and candy, and an even number of canned food, such as pork leg cans for the Hokkiens, Teochews, and Hainanese, and abalone for Cantonese and Hakkas. So other than all these food items, right, candles are also being brought over, and different dialect groups will bring over different types of candles. So please check with us before you buy your candles to be sure that you actually get the correct ones. So these candles will be brought over on Guo Da Li in pairs. So there's two boxes. And the bride's family will keep one box and return one box to the groom. So on the wedding day itself, the candles are to be lit together at the same time. So either you all can have a predetermined time, say 7 o'clock, light the candles, or set an alarm for this, very important. Or the groom's father can call the bride's father to say that we'll be lighting the candles in like 15 minutes. So please prepare. So if you have an altar, 一个神台, 点在神台, you light it up at the altar. 如果你没有神台, if you don't have one, 你拿一个桌子向窗外一点, so you prepare a small table and then put the candles on it and face the window. Just make sure if your place is has very strong wind, right, don't open the windows too widely. Yeah, just make sure you close it a bit. So all these items that I mentioned before, all these items will actually be prepared in pairs, 成双成对的带去女家, and carried over in traditional tiered wedding baskets. So with the more tiers, the better. So you can see, we have the baskets in this picture. So these baskets actually represent prosperity. So with the more tiers, the better, representing more and more prosperity for the couple in the future. So in Singapore, due to our diverse roots from the different dialect groups, different food items and different types of jewelry are being used for Guo Da Li. So in order not to confuse everyone, I will not delve into the specific dialects today. If you are interested to find out more, please contact us or come in for a Zoom session with us later from between 2 to 6 p.m. after this webinar, and then we can advise you accordingly to your own dialect groups. It'll be a personalized consultation. So next, who is involved in the Guo Da Li? Traditionally, Mei Po is involved in the Guo Da Li, but nowadays you can bring an elder aunt to accompany the groom. So two people will have to be involved, either the groom and one more auntie will come along as well. So where is the Guo Da Li being held? The groom will bring all these items to the bride's family's house. So it will be at the bride's house, and pass the gifts personally to the bride's parents. So the bride's parents will keep half the gifts and return half back, and also pass over dowry items to the groom for him to bring back to decorate the matrimonial room. Okay, so this is done. Now that we have covered the groom side, a lot of people will ask, so what will the bride's side give to the groom? So the bride's side will actually prepare something called 嫁妆, which is the dowry, not to give to the groom's parents, actually. A lot of people think that these are gifts for the groom's parents, but they're not. They're actually gifts for the couple themselves. So why is there a need to prepare the 嫁妆? So 嫁妆 is actually prepared by the bride's parents to bless the couple. And it usually represents the best blessings that a parent can have for their daughter. So items usually consist of daily necessities, which are necessary to starting a new home. And this includes like the sewing kits, 针线盒代表贤妻良母的意思，内外兼备. Then baby prosperity sets, which代表早生贵子的意思. So all these are to be prepared during Guo Da Li and passed to the groom. So what other things do you need to prepare? We have tea sets and bowl sets are to be given to the couple. These sets are first used in the groom's house on the wedding day for the tea ceremony, and to 吃汤圆. So this is also 代表, 吃汤圆代表圆圆满满. So 敬茶代表敬孝心. After the tea ceremony and after eating the 汤圆, these sets are actually kept by the couple. It also 代表以后他们的孩子敬他们的孝心. Yeah, 那对碗也代表丰衣足食的意思. It represents abundance. So traditionally, we also have the wooden clocks to be worn by the couple on the night before the wedding, representing 步步高升的意思, Nowadays, miniatures are actually displayed in the room because we don't advise you to wear clocks, because nowadays we don't stay in kampongs anymore, we stay in flats. So there's actually people staying below us. So it's not nice to, you know, stamp around their house in the middle of the night in clocks. So nowadays we have the small ones to be placed in the bridal room. So the couple wears bedroom slippers. So 把你的脚跟垫起来，富贵明的意思. So they wear bedroom slippers instead the night before the wedding. So we have got towels as well. Towels represent 白头到老. These towels are actually to be used on the first day of your wedding day in your bridal room. So let's say if you stay in a hotel, you stay there, and then after that, the first day you return to your bridal room, that's when you actually use the towels. You don't have to bring them to the hotel. And we also have a pair of lamps. So 这个子孙灯 is actually to continue the line of descendants, 延续香火的意思. And is to be placed on the left-hand side of the bed. During anchuang, left hand side means when you lie down on your left hand side, and is to be placed together and to be lit for 24 hours of your wedding day. Okay, so after the wedding, you can place one on each side of the bed. It's okay, but on the wedding day itself, the night before the wedding, you have to place both together on the left hand side of the bed. So, 男左女右的意思, this is to because it's to 延续香火, so 天南丁, so 男左女右 is placed on the left hand side. So a pair of charcoal is also given. It's the meaning of charcoal is 火炭. I mean, the charcoal is called 火炭. So it's 多多炭炭. So it's actually for the groom to earn a lot of money. So next time he has the ability to take care of his bride, to take care of his wife. So other than all this, we also have new bed sheets used in the bridal room during the bed setting. 安床的时候要用. So a lot of people will ask whether you need to buy a new bed for anchuang. That really depends. If your new house is not here yet, then you might not want to buy a new bed. But very importantly, you have to set a bridal room, whether it's in the bride's house or in the groom's house for the anchuang. So at least change in the new bed sheets. If you're not getting new beds, change in the new bed sheets and then set the bed and decorate up the entire room to welcome the bride into the house. So this will represent the beginnings of a sweet and loving life together, 幸福美满的意思. And it also represents a place that you can return to as a married couple. So when your new house comes and then you have your new bed and you move into your new house, that's when you can anchuang again if you want to. If not, then the first time anchuang during the wedding day is actually very important. So back to the dowry. When is the dowry given? So upon arrival of the groom on Guo Da Li Day, the bride will accept part of the betrothal gifts and pass your dowry items over to the groom to bring back home. So all these dowry items will be brought back to the groom's house, shown to the groom's parents, and displayed inside the couple's bridal room, the Xin Fang, during the wedding day for the auspicious meetings. And certain items will be used on the wedding day itself, like the tea set, bowl set. So that has to be taken off the boxes and washed and prepared for the wedding day to be used. Okay, so Dan, if you have any other questions regarding the specific dialect groups, please contact us via these communication channels, or you can come in for a Zoom meeting with us after that, and we'll be happy to discuss further. And we also have some other questions from couples. Before we answer the couples Q&A, we also have some other questions that is commonly asked. So for example, we have gotten our new house and are already staying in, preparing to move in after the wedding day. So do we set the bed at our new house or at our parents' house? So you set the bed at the place that you're going to stay after the wedding. So let's say your new house is ready, all renovated and nicely done already, you set the bed at the new house. So let's say your new house is here, you just collected the keys, but the renovation is not ready and it cannot be done up in time for your wedding. Please set the bed at your parents' house, and then after that, when the renovation is done already, then you move into your new house and you can decide whether you want to set the bed again there. Okay, so it's either or, depending on whether your house is fully ready or not. So if it's ready, set it at a new house. So we'll be marrying off from the hotel. There may be insufficient time to perform some traditional wedding customs. So what should we do? Right. Okay. Sometimes either the bride or the groom are actually from another country. So one of them will be staying at a hotel, or nowadays, the hotels are actually giving very, very, very nice perks, such as, you know, you can stay 2 or 3 nights in the bridal room. So a lot of couples will want to move in before the wedding to save time and to prepare themselves for the wedding day itself. So let's say you're marrying off from the hotel and and you're having a luncheon. So there's not enough time to perform traditional wedding customs. What you can do is you can hold the tea ceremony at the hotel itself. So before you decide to do this though, I would advise you to ask your parents about this, because a lot of parents might feel that they would want you to have the tea ceremony at their house instead. So what you can do is, if they prefer to have the tea ceremony at their house, you can have the tea ceremony for your parents and maybe your grandparents also at your house, and have the tea ceremony for your uncles and aunties at the hotel. So this can be done as well to save time from traveling here and there. Okay. So so tea ceremony can all be held at one place. So just be aware that if you're holding the tea ceremony in one place, please hold the tea ceremony for the groom side first. Complete the groom side before you go on to the bride side. So you when I say complete the groom side, means you do the tea ceremony for the groom's parents, the grandparents, and all the aunties and uncles and at the groom side first before you go on to the bride side, and then you do the same sequence. Okay. Okay, then the next question is it a must to have a baby boy to jump on the bed before or after the bed setting? Okay, there's two times that you can have a baby boy to jump on the bed. So you can actually do it during the bed setting. During the bed setting, after you change the bed sheets, before you place the tray on the bed, you can actually have a little boy jump on the bed, 在床上滚来滚去啦，不用一不一定要跳, so that he can actually roll on the bed as well. So, and then after he roll, you can actually put the tray onto the bed itself. So after the tray is placed on the bed, please do not touch the bed anymore. And then another, all the way until the wedding day itself, this is the next time that the little boy can jump. On the wedding day itself, when the groom brings the bride into the house, they will go into the room, and then that's when they will lift the bed setting tray up from the bed, and they will sit on the bed and sit hang yuan. So this is another time that the little boy can jump as well. So there's two timings. So if you are setting your bed very late at night and the little boy is sleeping already, please don't wake him up. You can actually do it the next day when you lift the tray up from the bed. Okay, so these two times you can do it, and just important, very important to remember to prepare a little red packet for the little boy after he jump on the bed to give it to him. Okay, okay. So now let's answer some questions from everyone. So question number one, who will have to accompany the groom to the bride's place during Guo Da Li? Actually, it's best to have an auntie, an elder, accompany the groom. Traditionally, the groom's parents do not go. A lot of people thought that the groom's parents can go. Traditionally, the groom's parents actually go to the bride's house to tea ting. And tea ting is actually before Guo Da Li, not on Guo Da Li day itself. So the groom's parents don't go to the bride's house on Guo Da Li day. An elder aunt or a good friend can actually accompany the groom. 如果找不到一个 auntie 来讲的话, a good friend can also accompany the groom. Best for the friend to be married so that he can actually guide the groom along. So 两个人要一起过去. Okay. So the tea for the ceremony. Do we have to finish the tea when people jing cha to us? Wow, okay, interesting. The tea for the ceremony, do we have to finish the tea? Actually, don't need. So actually, most of the time, the tea cup is actually quite small. And please don't pour the tea fully. Pour it halfway, because a lot of the tea cup is quite small, so you don't really want to spill the tea out onto the bride's dress or the groom's suit. So pour it halfway for the people who's helping to pour it halfway, so that when they serve the tea, the tea will not spill and it's easy to finish as well. But even if you don't finish the tea when people think tattoo, it's fine as well. You don't really have to fully finish it. It's fine to leave a bit inside. Okay. And then are these prepared by the daughter's parents or just the couple prepare this? Ah, okay, this is a very good question. A lot of people will ask, are the Guo Da Li items prepared by the couple or prepared by the groom's parents? Okay, traditionally, is prepared by the groom's parents, and the couple's parents, sorry, for the, is prepared by the bride's parents and the groom's parents. Traditionally, it's prepared by parents. That's because traditionally, we get married quite young. So a lot of us are actually still studying or not working yet or haven't saved up enough money yet when we get married. So the groom's parents will actually help to prepare all everything. But nowadays, right, people are getting married older. And because of this, a lot of parents are actually retired when the couple gets married. So in that case, it's actually the couple who has more than the parents. So maybe the couple can take up this portion of the wedding and help out their parents who are actually retired. So to be honest, nowadays in modern times, it's entirely up to the both of you to discuss or to decide who's paying for everything. So it's not that important anymore. So the person who can just can pay for it. Okay. And then, somebody is asking, when is our shop officially open after the circuit breaker period? Okay, we were hoping to open on the 2nd of June, but unfortunately, we are not in phase one. So we are actually in phase two, which is at least 4 weeks after phase one. So the earliest we can open is 30th June, subjective to further government. So phase two is actually in held over many months. So when exactly are we in phase two and are we allowed to open? It really depends on the government. So like all of you, we are also waiting for the government to tell us when will the retail shops be open. So we are part of retail shops. So once the government say retail shops can open, we will be open. Okay, so if you really want us to notify you when we open, please contact us and then we'll send you a notification when we have the exact date that we can open up. Okay, and hi Michelle, can we find out if the bridal room can be done in a hotel? Actually, I would advise not to. So it's best to be done in at a permanent place that you go back to after your wedding. So let's say both of you are working overseas and then your parents' houses are in Singapore. It's fine. Still do it at one of your parents' houses, okay? And if your new house is not done, just do it at one of your parents' houses instead of doing it at a hotel. If not, right, you can set up your room overseas where you are staying as a bridal room as well. So best to do it at a place that you return to after your wedding. So that's where your bridal room should be set, okay? And as permanent as possible, try not to do it in a hotel. So may I know how do we go about doing the tea ceremony on the wedding day? Okay, so as I mentioned, tea ceremony can actually be done in various places. The most traditional form is actually at your parents' place. So on the wedding day itself, the groom will actually set off to fetch the bride. And once reaching the bride's house, there'll be a gate crashing and then he'll go and fetch the bride after the gate crashing. You don't serve tea to your parents at that time. You actually fetch the bride, leave the house and then go back to the groom's house for the tea ceremony. So do the tea ceremony at the groom's house first. And then after that, the bride will actually change into a tea dress, or if you don't want to change, it's fine also. You go back to the groom's to go back to the bride's house after the tea ceremony at the groom's house. So after going back to the bride's house, that's when you do the tea ceremony in the afternoon. So first you do the tea ceremony at the groom's house, then you do the tea ceremony at the bride's house. And then lastly, if there's any uncles or aunties that didn't appear at the tea ceremony in the morning, you can actually serve tea to them at the dinner at night. So this is how we actually do the tea ceremony on the wedding day. Okay, so if it's all done at the same place in a hotel, for example, please be sure to serve tea to the groom's family first, complete the entire, all the relatives, and then after that, followed by the bride's family. Okay, then let me scroll down. So is there an elderly female matchmaker required for the customs? Traditionally, yes. And that is because traditionally, the couples normally don't know each other. 是, 他们没有见过对方的, 是父母, 父母决定的一个姻缘. So nowadays, because the couple most of the time has already been together for some time before they decide to get married, so this matchmaker is actually not necessary anymore. With that said, it is still best to have an elder, elderly auntie, elder aunt. Not, don't have to be elderly, but elder aunt to accompany the groom to go over on Guo Da Li Day to handle the, it's just to accompany him. Actually, presenting of the food items and everything is best done by the groom himself to show his sincerity. But of course, if you engage a professional matchmaker, then all this will be done by the professional matchmaker, okay? So, hi, as you mentioned, we need a baby boy to jump or roll on a bed. But what if we don't have any relatives who are baby boys? Any alternatives? Okay, number one, it has to be a boy. Number two, it has to be a tong nan, means as young as possible. So if you don't have any relatives who are young boys, you can actually, it doesn't have to be a baby, but as young as possible. So if you really don't have, try to borrow from friends who are married or neighbors. Yeah. And if you really don't have, right, it's okay to skip this part. It's not a must to have a baby boy to jump on the bed. You just set the bed. Yeah, that's fine as well. So it's not a must. Don't worry. Okay. And then for unmarried siblings, do we need to 敬茶 to them? For unmarried elder siblings, yes, you have to 敬茶 to them. So it's not about whether you are married or not, it's about 辈分. So it's about as long as you have elder siblings, your elder sibling will sit down. If they're unmarried, they'll sit down alone. If they're married, they will sit down with their spouse, and then you will have to 敬茶 to them. And then if you have younger siblings, you will, the both of you will sit down, and then your younger siblings will 敬茶 to the both of you. So if your younger siblings are married, they also will have to 敬茶 to the both of you. So both your younger sibling and the spouse will actually 敬茶 to the both of you, even if they're married. And if they're unmarried, they will actually 敬茶 to the both of you by themselves. Okay? And then we have the next question. Sorry, I need to scroll down first. Can you hold both the tea ceremony at the bride's place? Okay, this question is best to be answered by your parents, to be honest. So if both your parents are okay with it, I'm sure it's fine. But if either one of the parents have reservations on this, maybe you want to hold one side at the hotel or the restaurant that you'll be holding your banquet. Okay. So, what is the usual flow of serving the tea? Is it grandparents, then parents, then married siblings? Okay. A lot of people feel that it's grandparents first because they are the eldest. Actually, no. 结婚那一天, your parents 最大, 因为他们叫女儿娶媳妇, so it's actually parents first. So very importantly, serve the parents first. So after the parents, you move on to your father's parents. So that's when your father's side's grandparents will have the tea ceremony. So immediately after the parents will be the father's parents. So your paternal grandparents, followed by your father's brothers, elders to the youngest, followed by your father's aunties, elders to the youngest. So even if your father's first sibling is an auntie, you don't serve tea to the eldest aunt first. You serve tea to the eldest uncle first. So 是男先, 然后才到女. So serve tea to the father's brothers, eldest to the youngest brother, then followed by the sister's eldest to the youngest aunties. Okay? Then after that, you go on to your mother's side and your mother's parents, so your maternal grandparents, then followed by your mother's eldest brother to the youngest brother and mother's eldest sister to the youngest sister. And then it will be your elder siblings, and then followed by your sit down, and your younger siblings will 敬茶 to the both of you. Okay? Okay, next. Do we sell the 过大礼 and 嫁妆 package? Can we share the price? Can. We can share the price with you after we know your dialect group, because it differs by dialect group. So it's best to actually come to us individually, and we will actually advise you accordingly to your dialect groups, because all the dialect groups are actually different pricing. Okay, so you don't have to wait until our shops open. You can actually request for webinar sessions with us via Zoom. Later, we'll be there from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. to answer all your questions as well individually. And or you can actually Facebook or email us. And then Must the bridal room be at the groom's side or can it be at the bride's side? Good question. It can be at either. So if your parents are okay with it, it can be at the bride's side as well. But most importantly, please make sure that your parents are comfortable with these arrangements. So all this sorted out with your parents, discuss with them, and you'll be able to know the answer better. So from our end, it can be on either side. So is gate crashing necessary? Actually, it's a tradition whereby gate crashing is a tradition whereby it shows that the bride's family 不舍得让女儿嫁出去的意思. So the groom have to 经历过 a few trials and difficulties to actually marry their daughter. So whether it's necessary or not, it also depends on individually. So if you feel that you don't have the time, or if you feel that you don't really want to do it, it's fine. So do something that goes along with your heart, because it's your wedding after all. So discuss with the parents. If your parents are okay with no gate crashing, it's okay to do without. So most importantly, keep your communications open. Discuss with your partner and discuss with your parents, everybody involved, and then decide from there, okay? For the tang yuan, do we have it at the groom's room or the bride's room? You have it in the bridal room. So if your bridal room is in the groom's room, you have it in the groom's room. If it's at the bride's house, you actually have it at the bride's house. But traditionally, tang yuan is actually eaten at the groom's house, or at if you have a new house, you have it at a new house. 它是结圆房的意思，就是圆圆满满. That's why you have it in your bedroom. And then at the bride's house, traditionally 是吃面线或者是吃甜品，甜甜蜜蜜的意思，或者长长久久的意思. So 汤圆圆圆满满是在男家吃的. Okay. So is it necessary to go back to the bride's house for tea with her parents, or can we do it at the hotel straight? So if your family is okay to do it at the hotel, your parents are okay with it, and you want to save some time, yes, you can actually do the bride's family's tea ceremony at the hotel. Okay, so ask your parents for this. If they're okay, it's okay. Is there any professional matchmaker that we can recommend? Okay, professional matchmaker nowadays, right? We don't have any recommendations, I'm sorry. But you can actually ask around or search online. Just make sure some people would like to match their 生辰八字 together with the matchmaker. So you might want to ask them about all this, okay? So, and then ask your master as well, if you want to count all the animal signs and all this and the timings. Okay, on opening the car door for the groom, must it be the youngest male in the bride's family, or can my sister be a substitute instead? Okay, it doesn't have to be the youngest male, but it does have to be a male younger than the bride. Okay, so 不需要最小的, but 一定是要男的, 也一定要 be bride 小. So sister cannot, I'm sorry. So if you don't have a younger brother, you can actually have a younger cousin. No younger cousin, it can actually be a younger nephew. No nephew can be a very good friend, or it can be a neighbor as well. So as close as possible, as long as it's younger than the bride, and must be a male, okay? Okay. The next one is, you mentioned elderly aunt for Guo Da Li. Are you referring to an auntie one generation above? Yes. So so it's either your father's sister or your mother's sister, or if not, if you have an elder sister who's married, also can. Okay. So for the baby boy, it must be from the groom's side, or can we have a baby boy for the bride's side? Oh, this must be for the antuang. Yes, it can be from the bride's side as well, as long as it's a 小男童就可以了. It can be either from either side. Okay. Is Tong Nan best to be born in the year of the dragon, or is this not necessary? Okay. This one is subjective as well. Certain people feel that the Tong Nan is best to be born in the year of the dragon, but yes, it's also not necessary. So if you can't find a boy that is born in the year of the dragon, it's fine. Any year also can. But if you want to 算日子, all these things, or 算 the 生肖, maybe you can, your 师父 a better advice on that day, which 生肖 cannot jump on the bed, okay? And then Maybe I can answer like, you know, three more questions because we are actually exceeding our time. For those questions that we never answer, please come to us at our webinar, okay? So if we are doing solemnization before the banquet, does the tea ceremony have to be done before or after the solemnization? Okay, this one doesn't matter. You can, if you say solemnization is actually your wedding day, it's actually the Western version of getting married. The tea ceremony is actually the Chinese version of getting married. So it doesn't matter whether it's before or after the solemnization, as long as you do the tea ceremony itself before the banquet, okay? So when doing the ceremony, is there anything the couple need to say to the elders? When doing the ceremony, let me assume that this is the tea ceremony. Is there anything the couple need to say to the elders? There is nothing that you need to say. If you engage a professional maypo, there will be a lot of tea that she can say. If there's no professional maypo, right? Maybe when you're serving tea to the bride's parents, the groom can say something like, you know, I promise to take care of her. And then, you know, when you're the bride serving tea to the groom's parents, she can say something similar. So it's nice, but it's not necessary. Okay. And then, they just told us that we can have the time until 1:50. So maybe you can answer a few more questions. So it's 1:43 now, got seven minutes. I'll try to be fast. Hi, Michelle. Do we change out of the white bridal gown before or after the tea ceremony? Okay, you change it out after the tea ceremony at the groom's house. So at the tea ceremony at the groom's house, you'll be still wearing a white gown. And then after that, you change out into your tea dress after the tea ceremony at the groom's house. Okay, so first have the tea ceremony with the groom's parents in your white gown. Then you change out and then you have the tea ceremony with the bride's family in a tea dress. Okay. So do we follow the dialect group of the groom or the bride? This is a very common question. It really depends on situation. There's certain situation that you follow the dialect group of the groom and there's certain situation that you follow the dialect group of the bride. So this question is best asked personally in a one-to-one consultation so that we don't confuse everybody. Okay, so you can come to us for this question and then we'll answer you personally. And then we have got, so is my if my fiance and my dialect group is different, what package should I get? Same thing. Well, it depends on what are the exact dialect groups of both. And we can let you know. You can come to us for this question. We can answer you personally for this question. And then let me scroll down. Hi, Michelle. After Anchuang at the groom's house, is it a must to use back the same bed that we Anchuang before? Okay, after Anchuang at the groom's house, is it a must to use back the same bed? So are you asking because the bed at the groom's house is old and then you might move into a new house and you have a new bed? That's fine as well. So if you move into a new house and you have a new bed, you might want to Anchuang again, but if you don't want, it's fine. So you can actually Anchuang at the groom's house first, have a bridal room, have your Anchuang there, and then after that, when you shift in the new house, you can buy a new bed. It's okay also. Okay, just importantly, change your new bed sheets and keep your new bed sheets lah. Okay. And then is it possible for us to do Guo Da Li and Anchuang even though we are already married but haven't hold a banquet yet? So when you say you are married but haven't hold a banquet yet, I would assume that you solemnize already, but you haven't hold banquet. So you can do your Anchuang and Guo Da Li, yes. So you solemnize already, you sign paper already, you can still do your Anchuang and your Guo Da Li. So even, and then after you can hold a banquet after. So even if you solemnize already and you don't know when you're going to do your banquet because of COVID now, some people might think that it's going to be 2 or 3 years later. So also you can actually do your Guo Da Li Anchuang now. So it's fine because your new house is coming, right? A lot of people, new house is coming. So you can actually do your Guo Da Li Anchuang before moving into your new house, okay? So who started the gate crashing games tradition? A good question there. Let me go and find that out and I can answer that question. It's actually a tradition very, very long ago already. So even further before that, right, it's not actually a gate crashing games tradition. It's actually a Nao Dong Fang. So Nao Dong Fang is still popular in China now. So they don't do it before the wedding. They do it after the banquet where they crash into the Dong Fang and they Nao Dong Fang. So whether it's before or after, it's still a games that they play happily together with brothers and sisters. So it's still going on now. And then we have, is it true that the tongue must be swallowed and cannot bite so that we are my man? Okay, actually no. So nowadays the tongue sometimes got feeling, it's quite big. Please don't choke. So please bite if you actually, to be true, is you don't have to finish the tongue yuan, but you don't have to swallow whole also. So please bite your tongue yuan, if it's too big, so that you don't choke. And then if let's say for example you get those with feeling, the big ones, try to get those with hua sheng, zao sheng gui zi de yi zi, it adds another tier of meaning to it. Yeah, okay. So please don't swallow the tongue yuan whole if it's too big. Okay. So what if we are already staying at our own place, and do we do the groom's part of the ceremony in our house or in the groom's parents' house? Traditionally, it's the groom's parents' house. So if you're already staying in your own place, you might have to travel to three houses. So from your own place, from the groom's house, they actually set off to the bride's house, fetch already, go back to the groom's house for the tea ceremony. Then after that, go back to your house for the zitangyuan, and then change into the dress, and then go back to the bride's house for the tea ceremony at the bride's house. That's the sequence. Traditionally, you have 3 days to complete this. That's why at the bride's house, right, it's called San Zhao Hui Men, so which only happens on the third day. But nowadays, because you want to save time and because you want to travel off for your honeymoon immediately after your banquet, or you're going to stay in a hotel and everything, so a lot of times, and also because in Singapore, we don't have to travel very far to Hui Men, so we do it all in the same day. So if you don't have time to go back to the bride's house on the wedding day itself, you can actually go back to the bride's family's house on the third day of your wedding. So third day starting the day of your wedding, the first day, the day of your wedding is actually the first day. So the second day is actually 明天. So the third day is actually 后天. So 你可以后天回去 你的娘家. Okay. So after the 安床 at the groom's house, is it to shift the 安床 bed to a new house? Oh, 不用啦. 如果是新床, of course you shift it to your new house lah. Okay, if it's an old bed and you want to buy a new bed, it's fine. You can leave it at the groom's house. Okay, so it's 1:49. Okay, let me ask one last question. Let me scroll down. Okay. Is it a must to have someone open the door for the bridal car? Okay, very good question. It is a must to have someone to welcome the groom at the bride's house. So you only prepare the younger boy at the bride's house. So if really don't have a boy from the bride's side, the groom's side can lend one. So a good brother, 一个兄弟可以去帮他开车门. But yes, it's a must to welcome the groom. So somebody must open the car door for him. It must be a boy younger than the bride, preferably. If really cannot, the groom's brother can go and open the car door for him and then get the red packet. So at the groom's house, so after the bride's house, right, the groom go upstairs, gate crash, fetch the bride and go back to the groom's house for the tea ceremony. That's when you actually don't need someone to open the door. The groom is in the car, so the groom can actually get out of the car and then after that go to the bride's side and open the car door for the bride and fetch her out. So this can be done by the groom at the groom's house. So if not, you want to prepare somebody to welcome both of them at the groom's house, please be aware that they are both in the car. So you have to prepare two little boys, two boys to open the car doors for them. Okay, so one at each side. So if you only prepare one boy, please open the car door at the groom's side. Okay, ask the boy to prepare to open the car door at the groom's side so that the groom can get down and the groom can go and fetch his bride out. Okay, so either two
at the groom side, or you prepare one at the groom side. Okay. Okay, so this is the last question I can answer. We are running out of time already. So for the rest of the questions, if you want to come into the webinar to join us from 2 to 6 p.m. and we'll answer the questions there. Okay, thank you very much, everyone.